The Ayala Group's integrated microelectronics recently launched with the U.S.-based Zero Motorcycles, the first high-powered e-motorcycle line here in the Philippines. And to tell us more about that, we're joined today by twin CEOs Arthur Tan of IMI Philippines and Sam Pushal of Zero Motorcycles. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us, Denise.
Now, congratulations on the successful establishment of the first e-bike factory in Laguna. Can you share with us, I guess, first, the vision behind this collaboration between both of your companies? Let's start with Arthur.
Oh, thank you. Well, basically, you know, a lot of this was actually stemmed from the fact that the transition from ICE type of mobility to EV requires a different set of technologies and manufacturing capabilities. And I think this is where the opportunity now rests for IMI in the Philippines, because we're basically an electronic manufacturing company with some capability in mechanical manufacturing. And this attribute is the one that's driving this transition in the EV market. And I think Sam will be able to explain further, you know, the process of how they decided to partner with IMI.
Sam, yeah, let's hear more
Art.
About it.
Sure. So look, for Zero, this is a key element in our strategy as we go forward. We are the largest full-power premium electric motorcycle brand in the world. We sell more motorcycles every year than our next six competitors combined. And we had a goal to both scale and globalize our operations and manufacturing to meet growing demand. As a part of that, we did an extensive search looking at over 200 potential partnerships and contract manufacturing relationships globally. We compared the skills of every one of those candidates against all of the subsystems that Zero has in its motorcycle, and this is one of the smartest and most complex vehicles on the planet. In our head, the ideal partner, as Art mentioned, would have a mix of industrial capabilities, and they would have world-class electronics manufacturing capabilities. And after the past year of development and working on building the partnership, we are firm in our convictions that there is no better region than the Philippines for this work for us, and that there is no better partner in the world than IMI for Zero Motorcycle.
Now, Sam, it's good that you brought up the region. I mean, you have the factory's location is in Calabarzon, which offers strategic advantages. You know, can you elaborate on the factors that influence this decision and how it benefits the overall production?
Sure. I think that if you look at it, the benefits, you know, I would get questions as we brought the plans forward, why the Philippines and why IMI? On the Philippines side, the trade relationships and a favorable tariff situation into the U.S. are obvious. I think that you have an education system that mirrors the one in the United States very carefully, which creates common ground. I think there are no language or cultural barriers. And beyond that, the work ethic and the amount of skilled labor in the Philippines with the people of the Philippines were a really natural fit for a product that we built.
Now, going back to you, Arthur, e-bikes, they've been gaining popularity as a sustainable and definitely, you know, an eco-friendly transportation solution. How do you envision this new factory contributing to the growth of the e-bike market? First, of course, locally, and hopefully, as we all hope, globally.
Yes. Well, as you know, this transition, this innovation change that's happening would require not just the product itself, but also demand that an infrastructure be able to handle this transition. And I think this is where the Ayala Group has put its forward thinking into making sure that we drive the ecosystem that's necessary in order to make this transition possible. Now, of course, the key element there would be the product. And so the partnership we had with Zero is, as what Sam said, this is the most advanced electric motorcycle in the world. And the complexity of being able to do that is a testament to what we are able to provide, not only here for the country, but also in the Philippines. So this is something that we're looking not just to serve the Philippine market, which is quite nascent, but also the global market, especially out in Europe and the rest of Asia. Now, we have to also understand that in the Philippines itself, we register more than 2 million motorcycles each year, as compared to the number of four-wheel registration that we need. And so as a major mode of transportation, and we know from a greenhouse effect, The Philippines is not as industrialized as the rest of the nation, so most of our carbon comes from transportation. And so being able to make that transition into the electric motorcycle not only cuts costs on the operating costs and the fuel and the fuel costs that's necessary in order to drive our economy, but in general allow us now to become the leader in this segment within the region.
Now, you have mentioned, Arthur, you brushed up on this about the state-of-the-art technology. Would like to go back to Sam to elaborate on this technology and the manufacturing processes employed in the factory to ensure the production of course, these high-quality bikes.
Sure. I think that if you were to look at the motorcycle itself, the industrial elements in the assembly are relatively similar to what you'd have in an internal combustion engine vehicle. I think the key area that creates a long-term and sustainable competitive advantage for Zero Motorcycles lies in the electric powertrain. The core components of that powertrain are our battery, our patented, we're on our third or fourth generation of an internal permanent magnet motor that is a patented motor that has incredibly high output and incredibly high efficiency in a very small package. And third would be, and probably most important, the software and firmware that is the operating system or the central nervous system of the vehicle and the associated electronics. Those are the key elements that set Zero apart from the competition, both internal combustion and electric. And the fact that those are the core elements that create the competitive advantage and sit at the heart of our brand and technology, it's a natural that with IMI's experience in electronics, that they were the partner that we chose. I'll say that this is the first partnership in our history, our 17-year history, where we have partnered with somebody on so many elements of the technology and the powertrain. IMI will be assembling our batteries, they'll be assembling our motors, they'll be building all of the electronics that sit at the core of the operating system that is the heart and soul of Zero Motorcycle.
Now let's get to know, I guess, as well, all the production processes. Now you mentioned, of course, the state of technology, you've elaborated, and we all know that supply chain management is really crucial for these things. Now, how do you plan to secure a stable supply of components and materials for the factory?
Yeah, I think Art would speak best to the sourcing and supply chain. What I will say is that over the course of the last 2 years, like every brand in an industrial space, shortages or constraints in lithium ion batteries and specifically in chips have forced us to create an architecture that's much more flexible. We redesigned our entire operating system and all the electronic components to not be reliant on a single microchip, but on a family of microchips, allowing us in the marketplace to find supply wherever we can to continue to fill that growing demand. What we're seeing is a normalization of those supply chains around some of those critical components. As far as the sourcing and supply chain management in production, Art's going to be the expert that talks about what they've actually built for us at IMI to make sure we have uninterrupted supply for the vehicles.
Art, could you tell us more about it?
Yes, thank you, Sam. Yeah, as what Sam has elaborated, so I think the key advantage that IMI has is that we've been already providing for the electric vehicle platform, not only for Zero as what we've started, but in the past for a lot of the different four-wheel OEMs globally. And so we've had already the experience of being able to provide and source for logistically and on supply chain basis where the critical components are in order to provide the subsystems that's necessary and to be built properly. The access that we have is on a global nature. As you know, IMI has a far-reaching global footprint, not only in Europe, but also in China and Asia and everywhere else and in the United States through Mexico. And so we're using all of that capability and experience that we've done, because to date, not only do we supply and provide this key element for Zero, but we do this for a lot of key four-wheel EV OEMs globally, and majority of them, of course, coming from the United States. So we're using that capability and expertise that's already in-house and making sure that we provide the key capabilities that Zero needs in order to meet its demands globally.
Now, Art, just a follow-up question. I guess now that we've established all of the things that the e-bike has to offer, and it is the first of its kind, you know, with the growing demand for electric mobility solutions, how do you plan to expand the reach here in the Philippine market and also establish a robust distribution and also service network?
That would be clearly a challenge. What I would hope for is that the government policies would then go in line with the exponential growth that is happening within our market. We should not look at the EV by motorcycle market purely on a Philippine sense, although this would be a determining factor. It should also be looked at as a way for the Philippines to leapfrog its neighbors and actually create a hub and spoke concept where we become the hub for the electric motorcycle market. I think this is where the partnership that we have with Zero, and I have to thank Sam and the team in Zero for choosing us to allow us to prove to the world that we can actually manage, we can actually produce, we can actually collaborate on these very complex EV vehicles and allow then the Philippines to be a base for future projects that may come in the four-wheel market.
I mean, Sam, do you have anything else to add to that of how this partnership and how you envision this new factory contributing to the growth of the e-bike market here in the Philippines?
Phil, I think Art nailed it. I think that if you look at the largest problem that we've faced as a business and the largest problem I've faced as CEO in the last 4 years is we had difficulty scaling our operations to meet fast growing global demand. I think that for us, growing in the Philippines and continuing to grow EV penetration in the Philippines will be a part of that. I think you see infrastructure investments in public charging infrastructure as a key leading indicator of demand. But we're not reliant solely on sales in the Philippines. We are actually partnering as well with IMI on the distribution of those motorcycles in the Philippines. And there is no better group that understands or has a passion for two-wheel than the team there. But for us, on the manufacturing side, distribution in the Philippines is of course important, but the scale and the pace is happening on a global basis. In the first few years, the majority of the motorcycles that IMI will be producing for us will be for export into the EU market, which we're sold in over 30 countries worldwide. It is our largest single region and our most important region, and they are going to be the manufacturer of record for all of those vehicles for us on an export basis.
Artan of IMI Philippines and Sam Pashal of Zero Motorcycles. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations again.
Thank you, Denise.
Thank you. Thanks, Denise.